In the third and final season of Dark, the apocalypse is nearly upon us. On the 27th of June 2020, destiny will be fulfilled and all the answers to the series' enigmas will be revealed. Yes, we know it's difficult to remember all of them. That's why we've put together this recap of the first two seasons. But to make it easier to understand, we've organised it by time period. Before we get started, let's remind ourselves of where Dark is set. Winden, a small, gloomy town in Germany, where a boy called Mikkel Nielsen goes missing. In this town, there are four families that, thanks to time travel, have more in common than they realise. As well as Mikkel's family, there are the Tiedemanns, the Karnvolds, and the Dopplers. There's another key thing I should mention before we get started. There are five different time periods in the show, each 33 years apart. 1921, 1953 to 54, 1986 to 87, 2019 to 20, and 2052 to 53. With all that said, we can begin. In this time period, Adam, whose face is disfigured due to extensive time travel, is living in Winden. He wants to control events in each of the different time periods to trigger the apocalypse. Adam is also the leader of Sic Mundus, a time-travelling secret society created in 1921. He has many subordinates who do his dirty work, but his main stooge is Noah. When Noah was young, he dug the cave that would allow them to time travel. Oh, and whilst he was doing it, he killed one of his friends who wanted to rebel against Adam. Yeah, Noah is ruthless and very loyal to his boss. Jonas Karnvold from 2019 accidentally arrives in this time period. He was trying to return to his own time period in the future, but instead ended up in 1921. He's then mistaken for a soldier and welcomed into the home of young Noah. Noah's sister is seemingly Agnes Nielsen, who will become another one of Sic Mundus' time travellers later on in the series. Agnes is, of course, the great-grandmother of Mikkel, the boy who goes missing in 2019, but we'll talk about this family connection later on. Young Noah takes Jonas to church, where adult Noah and Adam are. There, Jonas realises that he and Adam are the same person and that Adam intends to reach the third cycle of 33 years, thus provoking the apocalypse. Adam tells Jonas that the only way to stop this from happening is to travel back to the day before his father killed himself, which is what triggered the whole chain of events. And seeing as Jonas is a good guy, well, he believes Adam. So Jonas travels back to 2019 to try and stop his father killing himself, and we say goodbye to 1921. The events of this year all happen in 1 week, from the 5th to the 12th of November. In this time period, we see Bernd Doppler planning the construction of a nuclear power plant in Winden. Bernd is Helga's father, and an old man in 2019 shouting mysterious nonsense that nobody understands.
Es wird wieder passieren.
This is the same Helga who will have his face destroyed by Ulrich Nielsen from 2019, and the same Helga who will go on to become Noah's right-hand man. But let's take things in chronological order. Helga from 1986 travels in time and takes Erik Obendorf's body back to 1953. 4 days later, he brings back little Yasin Frieda's body too. Both went missing in 2019 and then appeared in the mysterious blue room in 1986 tied to a chair, which is actually an old-fashioned time-travelling machine. But let's just say that the chair doesn't work out very well and ends up killing them. Both the bodies have the same wounds, scorched eyes and ruptured eardrums. They also both appear on top of the mound of earth where construction of the nuclear power plant will begin. On the 10th of November 1953, the young Helga sees both bodies and the police inspecting the scene. Ulrich from 2019 travels to this day looking for his son, Mikkel, but he instead bumps into Trond, who is his father and, as if that wasn't enough, had only just arrived in Winden that very day with his mother Agnes. Ulrich is very confused and goes to ask the watchmaker H.G. Tannhaus about the book he wrote on time travel. He leaves his coat and his mobile phone there. Then he goes to the Doppler's cabin and, as we mentioned previously, tries to kill the young Helga in order to change the future and prevent the disappearance in Winden from happening. Ulrich hits him over the head with a rock, which leaves half of his face disfigured, but Helga doesn't die. Ulrich thinks he is dead and takes him to the bunker. Helga therefore disappears from his time period. That same night, Claudia Tiedemann gives the watchmaker the designs for a time machine which will work much better than a chair from 1986.
Was soll das sein?
Sagen wir, es ist etwas, das den Lauf der Zeit gerade rücken wird.
Egon Tiedemann, Claudia's father, is the town's policeman. He arrests Ulrich and accuses him of murdering the two boys who came from the future, as well as Helga, who is still missing. Meanwhile, Helge regains consciousness in his family's bunker following the blow to his head. A time portal opens up in the bunker from which he can see Jonas from 2019, trapped in the blue room in 1986, which is in fact the same bunker. They touch through the portal and Helge from 1953 is transported to the bunker in 1986. From the 23rd to the 26th of June this year, we see the mysterious return of young Helge. Noah had explained to him in 1986 that when he was older, he would help Noah. He warned him not to tell anyone about it and then sent him back to his time period. Agnes Nielsen is recently divorced and lives with her son, Trond, in the Tiedemann's house. Oh, and Agnes begins a secret love affair with Doris Tiedemann, Claudia Tiedemann's mother. So at this point, we know that Agnes is Trond's mother, Trond is Ulrich's father, and Ulrich is Mikkel's father. But let's get back to the story. Old Claudia from 2019, who appears from time to time in the different time periods, warns Agnes that she is to stop her brother Noah from trying to reach the third cycle and thus triggering the apocalypse.
Dein Bruder ist ein blinder Narr. All das Leid, das den Menschen bringt. Aber es wird ein Ende haben.
This same Claudia then goes to see her father, Aegon, at the police station to apologize for all the bad things that are going to happen to him. As expected, Aegon has no idea what she's talking about. Then Claudia goes out into the forest and is murdered by Noah. Young Helge finally wants to open up about his disappearance, but he's been doing wrong almost all of his life and thus tells Aegon that old Claudia is the source of the real evil instead.
Er hat mir von ihr erzählt. Dem weißen Teufel.
Something that Noah clearly asked him to say. Aegon is very confused. He suspects that he's not been told the truth and now questions whether Ulrich is really to blame. An explosion at Vinden's nuclear power plant in the summer of 1986 opens up a wormhole that connects to the Vindens of 1921, 1953, 1986, and 2019. On the 9th of October, Mads Nielsen, brother of Ulrich and son of Trond, goes missing. We know that Helge from that year was the one who kidnapped him and took him to the bunker. On the night of the 4th of November, Helge travels to 2019. Mads is also sent to 2019 using the defective time machine chair, which causes his death. The next day, Eric is sent to 1953 with the same lethal chair. Meanwhile, Mikkel from 2019 comes out of the cave and arrives in this time period. He realizes that he's traveled across time and meets the nurse Ines Carnvold, who later on decides to adopt him. Jonas from 2052 appears in this time period to have a chat with the watchmaker Tannhaus about wormholes for time travel. Helge gives Claudia the watchmaker's book as a present on her first day as director of the nuclear power plant. A few days later, Jonas from 2052 returns with the watchmaker so that he can repair his time machine, which is the same one the watchmaker started building based on the designs that Claudia gave him. In this time period, we also see Jonas from 2019 time travel using Vinden's caves, where he ended up whilst looking for Mikkel. When Jonas from 2019 sees Mikkel from afar in 1986, Jonas from 2052 appears behind him and asks him not to help Mikkel because he's where he needs to be.
Wenn du Mikkel jetzt zurückbringst, dann greifst du in den Lauf der Dinge ein. Dein Vater lernt deine Mutter nicht kennen, sie verlieben sich nicht, sie heiraten nicht. Und du, du wirst nicht geboren.
We still don't know why, but this enigma will be resolved in 2019. Because Jonas from 2019 doesn't understand what's going on, he keeps trying to bring Mikkel back. But Noah and Helge from 1986 stop him. Then Jonas wakes up to find himself locked in the bunker. From outside, Jonas from 2052 explains who he is. He goes to the caves to close a wormhole, but in the meantime, a time portal opens up in the bunker, which is the one we mentioned in 1953, which sends young Helge back to this time period, whilst the other Jonas is sent to 2052. Poor Ulrich is now locked in a psychiatric hospital. Aegon, who is now a retired police officer, works out that the man he arrested in 1953 is actually a time traveler who was indeed looking for his son. Perhaps to clear his conscience, Aegon goes to the psychiatric hospital and shows Ulrich a photo of Mikkel who has just arrived in 2019. As you would imagine, Ulrich gets very angry. Meanwhile, old Claudia visits Claudia from this time period to tell her about time travel and the role she'll have to fulfill. She also tells her that 33 years ago, she buried one of the time machines in her garden so that she would be able to use it. So Claudia travels to 2019 and finds out, amongst other things, that her father Aegon is going to die on the 26th of June, 1987. Aegon and Claudia don't get on well, and Claudia feels bad about this, so she decides to spend the day with him, without realizing that in doing so, she is filling Aegon's destiny. While they're arguing in the kitchen, she pushes him. Aegon hits his head and dies.
God, it's been well.
Rest in peace, Aegon Tiedemann. On the 20th of June, Jonas from 2019 arrives in this time period, but before his father Michael kills himself. He believes that if he manages to stop this event, just like Adam told him, that will stop any more cycles of 33 years and thus prevent the apocalypse. Jonas and his father talk about the subject, but Michael didn't have the intention of killing himself. He only gets the idea in his head after his chat with Jonas. It's here that we realize that the person responsible for all the misfortune to come is Jonas, and that he's ended up being just another one of Adam's puppets. The following day, Michael kills himself and leaves a letter for his son that should be opened on the 4th of November 2019 at 10:13 p.m. In this scene, we are once again reminded that it's not possible to change the future in Dark, because by attempting to, characters are actually writing it. During this time period, we also realize that Michael is in fact Mikkel, the boy who traveled to 1986 and who in 2019 has a family and is Jonas's father. Sadly, this means that Martha Nielsen, the girl who Jonas is in love with, is in fact his aunt, because she's Mikkel's older sister. Uh-oh. Next, we jump to the 4th of November, the day when old Helga begins shouting it will happen again. That day at 10:13 p.m, whilst the nurse reads the letter from adult Mikkel, the young Mikkel goes into the cave that will transport him to 1986. Helga's son, Peter Doppler, discovers Mads' body and searches for the answers alongside Trond Nielsen. Old Claudia appears and gives them a notebook that explains all events, past, present, and future. Jonas from 2052 appears in this time period and finds a map of the caves in adult Mikkel's study. Shortly after, he goes into Jonas's room and places markers on the map of the caves while he's sleeping so that he'll be able to find them and be able to time travel. Then he leaves him a package with his dad's letter and a lantern that looks as though it's been brought from the future. Meanwhile, Noah gives the young Elizabeth Doppler a clock for her mother, Charlotte Doppler, who is now Vinden's chief police constable. Ulrich searches for answers for the disappearance of his son with old Helga, but all he finds is the watchmaker Tannhauser's book, which leads him to the caves and takes him on a journey from which he won't return. Helga meanwhile travels to 1986 to convince his 1986 self not to kidnap the children, but he fails. Regina Tiedemann, whose hotel Jonas stayed at in 2052, finds all his notes on time travel and Sigmundus that he left behind in the room. Meanwhile, police officer Charlotte unearths more and more clues related to time travel and realizes that Ulrich's disappearance is due to a trip to 1953 from which he couldn't return. On the 21st of June, exactly 1 year after Mikkel's suicide, Jonas from 2052 is with Hannah, his mother, and he tells her everything about time travel. He also tells her that the apocalypse will start in 6 days, the same day on which the nuclear power plant was meant to be deactivated. She's not convinced that time travel is possible, so Jonas from 2052 takes her to 1987 so that she can see Mikkel. This is the same day we realise that the watchmaker Tannhaus was the one who raised Charlotte. As well as this, Elizabeth finds a photo from 1921 of the members of Sigmundus with Noah pictured among them. Claudia from 1987 travels to 2020 to ask forgiveness from her daughter Regina for having been a bad mother. Regina now has cancer. It's around now that Claudia also finds out the exact day her father Aegon is going to die, as well as the day she'll disappear. Charlotte already knows too much, so she goes with her husband Peter and with Hannah to her bunker. There they run into Jonas from 2052 and tell each other what's been happening and what's going to happen.
Er will, dass der letzte Zyklus beginnt. In 3 Tagen. Ich muss ihn stoppen.
On the 27th of June 2020, the day of the apocalypse, Jonas from 2052 meets up with Magnus Nielsen, Bartosz Tiedemann, and Franziska Doppler, and takes them to the future. These three kids are part of 2019 Jonas's friendship group, and were in the forest the night Mikkel disappeared. Jonas from 2019 is also in this time period and wants to save Martha, but Adam arrives and shoots her dead. Jonas is devastated, but then another Martha appears who seems to be from another dimension, not another time period.
Aus welcher Zeit bist du?
Die Frage ist nicht aus welcher Zeit, sondern aus welcher Welt.
In the end, the power plant explodes and the apocalypse starts. All Jonas's efforts to stop it have been in vain. The only thing we know about this time period is that the world was destroyed and very few humans survived. Elizabeth Doppler now leads a group of armed people. When Jonas from 2019 travels to this time period from 1986, they hang him. But in the end, Elizabeth doesn't let him die and he manages to escape. We also know that the God Particle can be found in the ruins of the power plants and that Elizabeth and her group kill anyone who tries to enter the ruins. Jonas from 2019 manages to survive on his own in this time period. One day he goes into the power plant and discovers a wormhole, but it's unstable and he needs more electricity to be able to stabilize it and time travel again. He finally manages to do it, but instead of being transported to 2019, he's taken to 1921. Elizabeth also goes into the power plants, and while the members of Sic Mundus from 1921 successfully stabilize all the wormholes, Elizabeth sees Charlotte, her mother, and they touch hands. What's going to happen in season 3 of Dark? Will there be interdimensional travel as well as time travel? Will someone finally manage to change the course of destiny and prevent the apocalypse? We'll find out on the 27th of June, the release date for the third and final season of Dark.